I've already talked about some of the forgotten maps of Counter-Strike, a series that I've still yet to complete, but there is actually a pretty large pool of removed content for the older Counter-Strike titles. Some are common knowledge, while some I haven't even heard of myself. Today I'd like to talk about some of the forgotten weapons of Counter-Strike, where they went, and why they probably didn't make it into later versions. The first and probably most well-known piece of removed content being the Tactical Shield. Essentially, it's what you'd expect, a ballistic shield that can be purchased by either side for a price of $2,200. The shield replaces the player's primary weapon, but can be used alongside pistols, with the exception of dual elites, of course. It's pretty obvious to see why this was removed from CS, as it was notoriously unfun to go up against, and could easily be abused by a team. Hence why most servers even to this day don't allow the purchase of the Tactical Shield in the buy menu. The Tactical Shield was featured in Counter-Strike as well as Counter-Strike Condition Zero, but was removed for Counter-Strike Source. However, it was re-added to Counter-Strike Global Offensive in the form of the Riot Shield, but is now only available in Casual Hostage Rescue mode. Any fans of Condition Zero will be familiar with the M60 machine gun featured in the game. The M60 is a high DPS heavy weapon with a fair amount of recoil, as anyone would expect from a gun firing such a large cartridge. It was primarily meant to be fired from a mounted position in real life, so the idea of it being fired from the shoulder like it is in game is a bit far-fetched. Due to its high damage output, it was primarily given to a few of the bosses in Condition Zero's deleted scenes campaign. Originally, the M60 was supposed to be featured in the original Counter-Strike, but was cut instead and made its way into Condition Zero and was never to be seen again. Any fans that have been playing for longer than the lifespan of CSGO will certainly recognize this gun. The K&M submachine gun is essentially just an H&K MP5, more specifically the Navy version titled the MP5N. It was a mid-powered submachine gun that was effective at close to medium range, especially on unarmored targets. Priced at $1,500 for both teams with the exclusion of the T's in the assassination game mode, it was a pretty viable option for eco or forced buy rounds. The K&M was featured in Counter-Strike, Counter-Strike Condition Zero, and Counter-Strike Source, but didn't make a return for CSGO and was replaced by the MP7. Although Valve did end up adding a different version in the form of the MP5 SD, essentially an MP5 with an integral suppressor, and could be swapped out in the slot for the MP7. Featured in Condition Zero deleted scenes, the M27 Law is a single-shot anti-tank rocket launcher that could be used by the player or by enemies. It's available for use in a number of missions, does a high amount of damage, and can be a real pain to go up against if you aren't expecting the enemy to be posted up with it around a corner or on a balcony. Originally, the idea was created by Gearbox Software, who did want to add it to a competitive setting of Counter-Strike, but of course this idea was quickly dismissed as it was objectively awful, and the Law never made it any further than Condition Zero deleted scenes. The machete was a weapon featured in Condition Zero deleted scenes as a weapon that only the T faction could use. It was originally planned to be usable by the player during the campaign, but was cut as a usable weapon outside of NPCs, most likely due to the fact that it really wouldn't have been much use against most of the firepower the AI was wielding. The machete was removed after deleted scenes and was never seen again, unless you count some of the fancy new knives in CSGO. Much like the machete, the landmine is a weapon featured solely in deleted scenes and only a few missions. They sit on the surface of the ground rather than being buried, so they are easily spotted and avoided by the player. It's pretty easy to see why this never made it into any other CS game, as it would have been incredibly frustrating to go up against as a T if the CTs just laid mines in every side entrance. So it was never officially usable by the player, and never made it past deleted scenes either. Now there are a lot of weapons that simply fall under the category of cut content, meaning that they never made it into any version of Counter-Strike officially, thus not a whole lot of information is provided on them, so I'll briefly list what I could find here. The Pancor Jackhammer, based on the real-world Jackhammer shotgun developed by Pancor. The 357 Magnum, based on the original Half-Life Smith & Wesson 357 Magnum. The Auto Crossbow, a crossbow firing poison-tipped bolts. The M79, based on the real-world M79 grenade launcher. The HK69, based on the real-world H&K HK69A1 grenade launcher. The CS Grenade, a grenade that would emit a cloud of toxic nerve gas. The Concussion Grenade, a grenade that would stun the enemy much like a flashbang, and the Suicide Belt. I'm sure we can guess what this one's for. There were also a number of weapons that were simply renamed or received slight alterations for later versions. The K&M45 Tactical became the USPS, the 228 Compact became the P226, the Leon 12-gauge Super became the Nova, the Schmidt Machine Pistol became the MP9, the IDF Defender became the Galil, and the wood design was swapped for a more modern polymer-like design. The Schmidt Scout became the SSG-08, the Krag 552 became the SG-553, and the Krag 550 Commando became the SCAR-20. So there you have it, a near full list of the forgotten weapons of older Counter-Strike games, as well as some of the cut content that never quite made it into any of them at all. This is really just the extent of what I was able to find when researching the topic a bit, and I think it's fair to say that it would be strange to imagine playing a CS game with any of these weapons being usable. That's all for today. If you enjoyed the video or have any ideas for videos you'd like to see me do, let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching.